Welcome students, this is lesson number 20. In this lesson I will talk about how to handle the total station for its safety and to make use of securely, and then I will like to discuss about the temporary adjustment of a total station. It is the prerequisite for all total station field work. So this lesson will be discussed under these following heads. After introducing the handling of the total stations, now I will explain the some criteria or the points which you should follow while using the total station, followed by how to set up the total station, that is also called temporary adjustment of total station, that includes three operations: fixing, centering and leveling, and sighting, followed by summary and review questions. Now for proper and efficient work, actually total station should be handled with a lot of care, because total station is a electronic instrument, so it should be, it is very sensitive, so we should be very much careful in handling it in during use, during transportation, and followed by whenever we will use the total station, first we should satisfy some primary criteria regarding its different access. So that those criteria we can satisfy through temporary adjustment, which is also called the setting operation. However, one thing we should ensure, that before we make use of the total station, all the permanent adjustment of a total station should be correct. So that is the prerequisite condition for making use of any total station. So now let me start with the handling of total station. So this is a total station. A total station is kept in this case. Whenever we will use this total station, first we have to take it out. Now whenever we will take it out, we should hold the handle of the instrument, and then only we should take it out. So we should be very much careful in it, how to take out the instrument from case. Now after we have taken it out, we will be need to fasten the instrument with the tripod stand. Now whenever we will use the tripod stand first, so before we walk, we have to fix this instrument on this tripod stand. So while fixing, we have to take care that this screw, fastening screw, should be done very firmly. So we have to be ensured that yes, fasten has been done securely. So this is what we should do during our work. Then when we will be transferring this station to some other station, we should never carry this together. We should first unfix the instrument using this unfixing screw. Then we have to take it, then we have to hold this instrument with the handle, and then we have to carry it like this. So carrying transportation of this instrument with holding on the handle is very important. While we will be transferring this instrument again to the case, first we should see whether these foot screws are in the middle or not. So we should see that this is in between these, and in some instrument there are some marking, so those would be easy for you to justify. Otherwise, through eye estimation you have to make it in between, and then only, and also these screws like this vertical plate main screw, then horizontal plate main screw, these screws should be open, it should not be fixed. Then only you should hold on the handle, and then you should keep it inside the case. So these are the important points which you should always follow before you use or during your use. And then if during experiment, if some rain or some water gets due to some rain or water it gets wet, you should nicely wipe the instrument and then only you should put inside the case. And while the tripods will be once your work is over, that tripod stand you should then in that case this foot screw should not be so hardly pressed, and it should be slightly so that it does not come out. It should not be tightly pressed. So these are the care we should take while using the total station. So these are the very simple precautions which we should follow during use of total station, and that will keep our instrument in good condition. Now next point is that setting of total station. That means we know that the total station has three fundamental axes. One is vertical axis, one is horizontal axis, and the third one is our axis line of sight, or axis of the axis or line of sight. Now before taking observation using total station, we must have vertical axis truly vertical and horizontal axis truly horizontal, and line of sight should be perpendicular to vertical axis. Now and the vertical axis should pass through the center of station. So these are the conditions we should follow to work with total station. Now to make the horizontal axis truly horizontal, this can be done by an operation called leveling, and the vertical axis of the total station should pass through the center of the station. That is called by centering and so before we take observation using total station, we need to level the instrument, we need to center the instrument. Further, to make our observation easy, we should place the instrument at certain height, and so we need to fix the instrument on tripod stand. So tripod stand. So this is the first thing we need to do. After that, we need to do the leveling and centering, or centering or leveling. That has to be done simultaneously, and followed by whatever we will see, or whatever the object we will see, that is called sighting. So sighting. So these are the four operations which are you need to do before taking any measurement, and these four operations like fixing, then leveling and centering, and then sighting. These four operations together are called temporary adjustment of total station. And this is prerequisite for any measurement or observation using per total station. So now I am that is what I will be discussing now. Fixing on tripod stand by means to fasten the instrument to the tripod stand, and not only that, this will also during fastening also we will carry out some approximate centering and leveling. Then we will do the centering, means we will make some operation which will make this instrument exactly on the station, that is called centering. And then we will go for leveling of the instrument, that means we will make the plates horizontal, and finally we will go for the sighting of the object, that means to make the object, image of the object fall on the plane of the reticle, and we can see the reticle clearly, and that is called sighting. So that is what we have to do, and then only we can go for any measurement using the our data collector. Now for fixing, as I told you, fixing means fastening the tripod stand, total station on the tripod stand. So I would like to show you how it is to be done. This is the tripod stand. First you have to open the screws, and then you make the stand it as best convenient to you. Then we spread the legs of this in such a way that it is well separated, and also we will like to set up on just on the top of the station. We will see that the there is this element. Through this we will look, and we will try to find out that the center of this hole is just on the top of the station. So this is the first thing we will do, that is the approximate centering, and also we will make this head of the tripod stand level, and that we have to do by eye estimation. So once it is done, that is called approximate leveling and centering. Now sometimes this may not be possible, then we have to make use of these tripod legs, sometimes taking it out or circumferentially to make this point, the center of this should be just above the station. So that has to be done. So once it is done, now I can see that our instrument is approximately above the center of the station, and also head of this approximately level. Now I will take out the instrument to fasten on it. So as I told you, instrument has to be taken out handle, and then you check. First we should check whether these foot screws are in the middle or not. If it is not, then we have to make it in the middle. So in the middle, so it is more or less it okay. Now we are placing it on the tripod head, and then we have to fasten it using this fixing screw. Now we have to check there in this, there is a circular bubble, as I told you. Now we have to check this circular bubble, whether there is a circular bubble like this, circular level in the which there is a circular bubble. So we should try to keep it as best as possible within this. Now we can see that the bubble is not in the middle. If the bubble is not in the middle, then we have to make use of these legs and to bring this bubble in the middle. So now you can see that we have done it, and now the bubble is, that it is exactly in the middle. So now I can see, now you have to see again through this optical plummet to find out whether the the instrument is exactly or more or less within the center of this or not. Now, if it is fine, otherwise you have to look through this and you have to adjust the legs to bring this instrument more or less in the middle. Not now, let us say the instrument location is somewhere here, our plummet, the point somewhere like this. That means in within a small circle the your axis should be passing through it. Now this is called approximate centering, and whenever we will make this bubble in the circular level somewhere like this, or maybe like this, maybe like this, or it may be like this, whatever it is. So like this, so this is called approximate leveling. Now these approximate centering and leveling, this part has to be done by making use of the tripod stands with these screws and all these things. So once we have brought this level bubble in the the center or near center of this circular level, and our vertical axis is somewhere around this, so our approximate now I can say that the fixing operation is over. Next I will like to go for leveling. Now leveling of the total station is being carried out to make the horizontal axis of the instrument truly horizontal. Now this is done by making use of the foot screws and the circular bubble, and also there is some electronic arrangement compensator. So making use of this, we can carry out the leveling operation nicely. Now this is actually generally in case of total station, centering and leveling has to be done simultaneously, because if we do the leveling then centering may be out. Again only centering if we do, then leveling will be disturbed. So leveling and centering has to be done simultaneously, and of course leveling work should be finished first and then finally centering is to be done, because we can open this screw and we can shift our instrument a bit, so finally we can do the centering operation. Now to carry out the leveling, as we have done, that the we can make this circular level with the bubble at the center, and then we can also if our bubble, if we fail to bring the bubble at the center like this, sometimes it may be difficult. So somewhere like this, you after long number of try, you may fail to bring the bubble like this. So in that case, we have to bring the bubble within the center by using the foot screws. So foot screws may be used to bring the bubble at the center if someone fails to do it using the tripod stand. So that is what it is written here. Now once this bubble is in the center, that means approximate leveling has been done. Now we can make it on to make use of compensator, you will see this is the same thing available here. Similar to the figure given shown here, and in this you can see that there are two axes. This is called x axis and this is called y axis in this instrument, and corresponding to both axes there will be one cross bubble shown in a window like this. This is the y bubble, here something like this, and there is a bubble like this is the x bubble. X bubble, this is the y bubble. Now we have to take the instrument parallel to any two of the foot screws, and then we can take the foot screws either inside or outside to now when it is like this. So I can say that the y bubble we are adjusting. So when the value is changing, so now this is the x bubble, we have to changing the x bubble. So by adjusting the foot screws we have to bring these to this place, and this one more or less this place. So you can see that there is a circular bubble which should be in the middle, and this both this longitudinal bubble, the bubble should be in the middle. So that will be the ideal condition for leveling. So that is we are trying to do. So now because we are moving here, there is a disturbance, so leveling has been disturbed. The instrument is so sensitive, but ultimately now it is in the middle, you can say. So we can say that the instrument is properly leveled. We should see through this optical plummet whether this instrument is also exactly centered or not. If it is, fine, otherwise if it is not, then we can open it and we can shift this instrument a bit. Now the instrument is exactly centered over the station as well as it is leveled. So now we then instrument is tightened. So leveling and centering has been done. Next, sighting. Now suppose with this instrument I like to observe the reflector here. Suppose this is the point. Suppose this is the point I like to observe. Suppose this is the point whose observation we like to take. So just on the on that point we will keep the reflector, and now if I want to make use of and take the reading, first I will like to orient through this collimator. I will like to rotate the total station about the vertical axis and find out whether this is in that line or not. So if it is so, then I will fix the horizontal circle main screw. Then I will first look through eyepiece and adjust this screw to see the crosshairs in the reticle. Then I will like to see through this, and I will find out whether this focusing screw of the objective lens I will rotate to see the now I can see that I am unable to see it, so I have to rotate this by opening the main horizontal main screw. Yes, now I can see it. Okay, so I can fix the horizontal main screw, and I have to see this now. Now I have rotated this telescope about its horizontal axis to see this, whether this reflector is seen or not. Now I can see, now I will fix the vertical main screw. Now I will like to make the fine adjustment using the horizontal and vertical tangent screw. So actually, in this prism there will be like this a lot of, and I have a reticle like this. So this point I am trying to coincide with this by using the fine adjustment, fine screw of the vertical as well as horizontal main screw. So now it is fine. So exactly I can see that point and very sharp image. Okay, so that is what is called sighting. So first I have oriented, I have moved this total station around the horizontal vertical axis by opening the horizontal scale main screw. Then once I find that, then using the vertical plate main screw I have oriented that thing. So now I can see the reticle is like this. So once it is done, that means my temporary adjustment is over. That means now already I had done the focusing of eyepiece screw, eyepiece lens to see the reticles, and that means this is the reticle clearly. I have focused the objective lens so that I can make this prism location and this reticle centered. So after this, now I can start taking observation by pressing the necessary buttons. So that's all about the setting or temporary adjustment of the total station. And the next class we will, in some other class I will like to take up how to really take the measurement. So with this I like to conclude today's class. So the summary is that for effective use of the total station, we should must handle our instrument with due care, and it should be minimum secured, securely kept. Since total station is an electronic instrument, it is very sensitive, so we should be very much careful in handling it. For taking any measurement or any field work or making any field work using total station, always we need to do the temporary adjustment of the instrument. Temporary adjustment of total station consisting of fixing, leveling and centering, and followed by sighting. However, one condition has to be always followed, that total station should always be permanently adjustment condition. The permanent adjustment conditions of the total station should be always there, then only we can start work with the total station. So and the in temporary adjustment, actually fixing is done first, where approximate centering and leveling is to be done, followed by final centering and leveling, and finally we have to carry out the sighting operation to before taking the measurement. With this I like to conclude today's class. And next class I will talk on how to do the measurement of distance using total station. Thank you.